And he showed me quite a few few things for God's Son. And that is a very beautiful place to be. The best place you can be is where God now speaks to you, speaks with you. Because that means He is concerned. That also means He loves you. If you look at the history of Israel, the worst time in Israel was when God kept quiet. In fact, they call it the awful silence of God. Awful silence. The fearful silence of God. God is not speaking. And when God is not speaking, you cannot even be aware whether you are on the right road or not. But when God speaks, whether He rebukes you, rebuke is love. Meaning He's loving you. He said, you are going on the wrong road. Please come back here. Hallelujah. So yesterday the Lord was speaking to me about the church in this land. And He took me to many churches. And He showed me the pulpit also. In fact, I see a particular pastor who is in sexual sin. Particular pastor. And what happens is this. I think he stays, somehow his mother stays where he stays. His mother, his own mother. And his mother, I think, had gone to a place. I can see that she has gone somewhere. But when she went somewhere, then he is caught up in sexual sin with a lady. And you know, for me, the Lord normally shows me everything. And I see everything. So I could see the detail of the immorality. But then, his mother arrives surprisingly. And I hear him. So I see everything and I hear him asking. In panic, there is a panic in the house. And the girl is there. And then he runs out. The door to the bedroom has some glass, like this glass. The mother is able to see them and then she runs to the kitchen. And then he runs, he dresses and runs to the mother. And then he asks the mother, when did you return? And I hear the word 7 p.m. Either train or bus. 7 p.m. bus or train, something like that. And many more the Lord has been showing me about the church. So that is the love I am talking about. That the Lord can see. Actually, the mother tells the girl, I have a lot of details. So the mother tells the girl that on my son I will not allow you. And many other conversations about the church and the pulpit. That is what I mean by love. God is loving the church. He's saying, run there and tell the church in Finland to repent and turn away from sin. Time is over. Time for sinning is over. The time for sin is over. And prepare the way. The Messiah is coming. So I am going to share a lot of conversation in that context. But let us begin from here now. Now, when the Bible talks about the coming of the Messiah, then it says, at the midnight hour,
ihan tuollainen keskiverainen kuin Mars.
In this vision of January 15th,
tässä tammikuun 15. päivän näyssä,
he makes me able to see their garment.
Hän antoi nähdä näiden ihmisten vaatetuksen.
And that is where the instruction is. Ja, the instruction of the church.
Ja se on ohjeita seurakunnalle liittyen tähän.
He shows me the garment, the holy garment.
Hän näytti mulle pyhät vaatetuksen.
And after he sees the holy garment,
ja pystyy näkemään ne pyhät vaatteet.
Then I come to Helsinki.
Sitten tulen Helsinkiin.
Meaning that is where the instruction is.
Ja tajuan, että tähän ne ohjeet kuuluu.
To prepare the garment of the church.
Tänne valmistamaan seurakunnan vaatetusta.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And it's so beautiful, beloved people.
Ja te olette niin kauniita, rakastetut ihmiset.
Because when I began to talk to Kenya about the garment of the church.
Koska kun minä aloin puhua Keniassa seurakunnan vaatetuksesta.
That is where revival began from.
Silloin herätys tuli siitä.
Hallelujah. In that place of the garment.
Koska me siinä vaatetussa sanomassa.
Then the Lord was able to point out how to prepare the
garment. Point out.
He was able to point the stains, the stains of the garment. The many stains of sexual immorality. The falsehood in the church, lies. Deception.
Petosta, mitä seurakunnassa on.
He was able to point out the postmodernism.
Hän pystyi näyttämään postmodernismia.
He was able to point out homosexuality.
Hän pystyi osoittamaan homoseksuaalisuutta.
Then he said, clean up the garment.
Hän sanoi, puhdistakaa vaatteet.
So that's where revival is.
Sitä on herätys.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because this is the revival of righteousness.
Koska tämä on vanhurskauden herätys.
The revival of holiness.
Tyyden herätys.
Okay, now, let me begin by showing you this.
Aloitan nyt näyttämään teille tämän.
This is on the web. This one we have on the web.
Tämä on meidän nettisivu.
On the website.
Nettisivu on tämä.
Yes, and all over the web.
Ja,
some people have shared it on Facebook, on WhatsApp.
Ihmiset ovat jakaneet tämän me Facebookissa ja WhatsAppissa tai eri paikoissa.
And it says,
ja sitä sanotaan,
prophecy alert.
Että profetia.
Alert. Alata, like to alert somebody, be warning, be careful.
Joo, äkkiä, että olkaa hereillä valvomaan.
It says prophecy alert.
Se siinä sanotaan, että tämmöinen äkillinen kiire profetia suuri uutinen.
Thank you very much. And then the title says the Messiah is coming.
Ja siinä otsikossa sanotaan, että Messias on tulossa.
And then
it
says vision of May 4th, 2014. May 4th, vision of May 4th, 2014.
Toukokuun 4. päivä, 2014, oli näkyy yöllä.
I want to use this to advance the conversation about the garment, which I'm beginning today.
Käyttää tätä viitteenä keskustelussa nyt liittyen tähän seuraavaan vaatetukseen.
And you are so going to understand as a nation of Finland.
Ja tulette ihan tämän Suomen kansana.
And many other nations here.
Ja on ollut muut kansat, jotka täällä ovat.
That actually the central message why I have come is the garment.
Että itse asiassa keskeinen sanoma, miksi sinulta vähennetty, on tämä vaatetus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So in this one here,
eli tässä tämä,
the Lord makes me fall asleep.
Herra on vaikuttanut uneen.
And then when I look up, I see the sun.
Ja kun katsoin sitten näin aurinko.
But it was not the sun.
Mutta se ei kuitenkaan ollut aurinko.
Because I realized that it was the glory of the Lord, because the rays were going to the ends of the earth, the ends of the earth.
Koska olikin Herran kirkkaus, koska ne säteet menivät ihan maan ääreen saakka joka suuntaan.
So actually, when you look from where I was looking, look like a beautiful dome, a design of a dome.
Eli itse asiassa kun katsoin, se näytti niin kuin semmoiselta kauniilta näeltä, joka suuntaan säteili.
And then after that the voice spoke.
Ja sen jälkeen ääni puhui.
Look, the Messiah is coming.
Katso, Messias on tulossa.
But he makes me know.
Mutta hän saattoi olla tiedän.
In my heart.
Sydämessäni.
That look, the Messiah is coming.
Että katso, Messias on tulossa.
But the church out there is not yet ready.
Mutta seurakunta siellä ympärissä ei ole vielä valmis.
So I understand, said, but the church out there is not yet ready.
Ymmärsin, että seurakunta ei vielä ole valmis.
And so look at this beloved people.
Ja niitä rakkaat ihmiset, katsokaa.
So when I looked towards my left, again left, It was as though,
oli ikään kuin,
because Finland, you have a sea, there is a sea, there is an ocean here.
Niin kuin on meri Suomen äärellä.
It was as though,
oli ikään kuin,
thank you very much, thank you, thank you. It was as though you were looking at the sea, the ocean.
Oli ikään kuin katsoin sitä merta kohti.
In the evening.
Illalla.
But on the other side of the ocean.
Mutta toisella puolella sitä merta.
There is a storm, rainstorm coming.
Siellä on suuri myrsky tulossa.
Because I saw like this, like lightning on the other side. Näin
se on isku siellä toisella puolella.
You know in the night when there is a storm like that.
On yö, eikä on myrsky, niin siellä on sama vähennys.
So that is the way it looked like.
Siitä se näytti.
And at that moment,
ja sitä hetkellä,
when it did come out,
kun oli niitä sama vähennyksiä,
I found myself on the ground.
Löysin itseäni lattialla.
And I was rolling on the soil.
Kierin siinä maassa.
Rolling. And I'm going to repeat for the viewers on TV exactly what happened to me in that vision. As I was rolling on the soil,
kun olin kierimässä siinä maassa,
I was weeping,
minä itkin,
and mourning,
ja olin,
and wailing,
ja
and crying very bitterly.
I
was doing this. I was doing that
sitä tein.
And crushing my teeth.
Ja kiristin hampaita.
I was grinding my teeth.
Hampaita.
I was grinding my teeth.
Hampaita ja kiristin.
And then.
Ja sitten.
After that, I woke up.
Sen jälkeen heräsin.
Listen, beloved people.
Kuulkaa, rakkaat ihmiset.
Then I understood.
Sitten ymmärsin.
That the Bible is the only book on the earth.
Että Raamattu on ainoa kirja maan päällä.
That must be
fulfilled.
Because that capture I saw that light that did
capture
was actually the twinkling of an eye, like the twinkling of an eye. When the Messiah comes, it will be like the twinkling of an eye. There will be no time to prepare. And that's why you understand that tonight is very important here. Because the time to prepare is now. In a flash, in the twinkling of an eye, we are going to read. Don't worry, don't worry about this. We are going to read that scripture. Because the way I have designed this message for this country is that today I will share with you about the garment. And then tomorrow I will now focus on the visitation of this cloud. So that you get the complete message that has brought revival to Kenya. That is 1 Corinthians 15, verse 50 on. Don't worry, we are going to read it tomorrow. So listen to me, beloved people. So you see that the Lord is able to show me the church that will not enter. That is the rolling of the soil.
Se oli sitä maassa kiemistä.
And the crushing of teeth. To the extent that when I woke up, I first went to the mirror to check my teeth. I got a crush on my teeth.
Kun nousin ylös, olin murskaantunut hampaita, jopa niin kovasti ne hampaita kiristellyt.
So I want to slowly and step by step begin to talk about the garment for the church at this hour.
Mitä askeleen mä puhua tästä seurakunnan vaatetuksesta tällä hetkellä?
And in the process,
ja siinä prosessissa,
you will hear me talk about the authority of the garment, the authority.
Kuulette minun puhumaan tämän vaatteen auktoriteetista.
What a beautiful message.
Mitä kaunis sana.
Because,
koska,
this is the hour to prepare the garment.
Tämä on se hetki valmistaa se vaatetus.
This is the hour.
Tämä on se hetki.
For the church in Finland.
Seurakunnalle Suomessa.
To take back the authority of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. takaa.
Entä silloin, kun mä saan ristin ja veren auktoriteetin takaisin?
Per costerla.
Ristin ja veren.
Then she can harvest the nation.
Silloin kansakunta.
Hallelujah.
Voimme saada sen.
So step by step.
Askel askel.
Can we go to the scripture that describes the coming of the Messiah and the midnight hour?
Voimmeko mennä kirjoituksiin, jossa kuvataan tätä seurakunnan aatetusta?
Turn with me to the book of Revelation chapter 19.
Ilmestyskirja 19. luku.
Verses 6 to verse 9.
Jakeet 6-9.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for inviting me here.
Kiitos, että kutsuit minut tänne.
This is very powerful because at the end of it, the church will enter into revival.
Tämä on tosi hyvä.
And this revival I'm talking about, the revival I'm talking about,
se herätys, josta puhun,
is separated from money. Money.
Se on erillään.
Separated. This is holy, holy.
Tämä on pyhä.
Holiness.
Pyhys.
It is separated.
Se on erillään.
From falsehood. False prophets, false apostles. That is something else.
Se on jotakin, mikä loppuu.
I am talking about entry of the church into the glorious kingdom of eternity. Instruction to empower the church to prepare to enter.
Niinpä Herra lähettänyt minulle antamaan ohjeita teille, että voitte edes astua sinne
seuraavaan. That when the nation will enter, when Kenya will enter,
että kansa astuu sisälle, seuraava astuu sisälle.
When Kenya will enter, when the nation will enter, then when you check there,
ja kun teitä tarkistetaan siellä,
you will see Finland also enter. Hallelujah. And South Korea. And internet people. Sweden, Netherlands, France. So now they all enter,
right?
I know I am addressing myself to Finland.
Tiedän nyt, keskityn Suomeen.
But it doesn't matter. That is you, even South Korea, right?
Myös eri ja muut kansat, se pätee myös
teille. Even those of you watching from Russia,
jopa ne, jotka katsovat esimerkiksi Venäjältä,
Sloveniasta,
many other nations that
may be tuned in.
Kansat, joita me ollaan mukana tässä.
When I address myself to the church in Finland,
kun puhutte ne seurakuntaa Suomessa,
even you, God is telling you, prepare.
Myös sinulle Jumala sanoo,
että Jumala sanoo. So listen, beloved people. Revelation chapter 19, verses 6 to 9. Revelation 19, 6 to 9. I'm going to read one verse and then you read one verse. Thank you so much. And you're doing very good. Sorry to say it live on TV. So, Revelation 19, verse 6. Then I heard what sounded like a great multitude, like the roar of rushing waters, and like loud peals of thunder shouting, Hallelujah! For our Lord God Almighty reigns.
Sitten minä näin ikään kuin suuren kansanjoukon äänen, kun suurten vetten pauhina, kuin voimakkaan upposen hyvinen sanoa, Halleluja, Herra meidän Jumalamme kaikki valtios on ottanut kuninkuuden.
Let us rejoice and be glad and give Him glory. For the day of the wedding of the Lamb has arrived, and His bride has made herself ready. Then He says, fine linen, finest linen, bright and clean, was given her to wear.
Kirkas morsian.
Yes. And he says, fine linen.
Hän sanoo, että lopulta
stands for the righteousness of the church.
Hän siinä seisoo seurakunnan vanhurskaus.
Can we repeat this verse now?
Voimmeko toistaa tämän jakeen vielä?
Okay. He says verse 7. Let us rejoice.
Ja 7 sanotaan siis iloitkaamme.
And be glad.
Ja hienoitkaamme.
And give Him glory.
Ja antakaamme kunnia hänelle.
For the day of the wedding of the Lamb has arrived. And His bride has made herself ready.
On aika on valmis.
And then he says,
ja sitten hän sanoo,
find him.
Ja hänen annettiin.
Right and clean.
Pukeutua puhtaasti.
Look at what was given.
Hänelle annettiin.
God gave, given.
Jumala antoi.
Free of charge.
Ilmaisesti.
In other words. So he said, find him.
Eli sanotaan.
Bright and clean.
Että se oli puhdas ja kohtaa.
He was given her.
Hänelle annettiin se.
To wear.
Käytettävästi.
And then he says.
Ja sitten sanotaan.
Find him.
Että se oli Petra vahvassa.
Sent for the righteous acts of the saints.
Petra vahvassa. Sinä olet vanhuskas pyhys.
Hallelujah. All the languages are on board, right?
Se Petra tarkoittaa sitä.
You're following beloved people. French and everything. And Italian. And then it goes on to finish by saying, he finishes by saying, then the angels say to me,
write,
blessed are those who are invited into the wedding feast of the Lamb. Then he says, these are the true words of God.
Nämä ovat tosi Jumalan sanoja.
So beloved people,
niin rakkaat ihmiset,
when I saw the church enter,
kun näin seurakunnan astuvan sisään,
this becomes my spiritual scripture, my central scripture, this one.
Se tapahtuu kirjoitusten mukaisesti.
For the message I want to bring to your beloved nations in Europe and specifically Finland.
Se sanoma, jonka haluan tuoda Euroopalle ja erityisesti Suomelle.
The coming of the Messiah at the
midnight
like a thief.
Niin kuin paras.
This is how the Bible celebrates that day.
Tällä tavalla Raamattu se esittää.
In fact, he says,
itse asiassa hän sanoo,
that when that day arrives,
että kun se päivä saapuu,
it is as if the entire heaven explodes into a huge celebration.
Se on niin kuin koko taivas vetää se valtavaan juhlintaan.
And he says a historic celebration.
Hän sanoo historiallisen juhlintaan.
Like multitudes and multitudes.
Jossa on kansanjoukkoja valtavat määrät.
Like the roar of rushing waters.
Niin.
Like loud peals of thunder. He is using that to say it is historic celebration.
Käyttää eri tapoja sanoa, että se on historiallista juhlintaa.
Meaning,
niin kuin Maria Petten Paulus.
That has never happened in heaven before.
On se juhlinta, mitä ei koskaan ennen tapahtunut teillä taivaassa. Askeleen rakkaat
ihmiset. And then,
ja sitten,
in that historic celebration,
siinä historiallisessa juhlinnassa,
you right away see the Lord speaking to Finland.
Näet, miten Herra puhuu Suomelle.
You hear the Lord say,
hän sanoo,
you hear the Lord say,
kuulet Herra sanoa,
that this is historic.
Tämä on historiallista.
This day that is coming.
Tänä päivänä, tämä mikä on
tullut.
Se on historiallista.
This event.
Tämä tapahtuu.
That is coming.
Joka on tulossa.
Is historic.
Se on historiallista.
Then he says.
Ja hän sanoo.
Celebration historic.
Että se juhlinta on historiallista.
And when you follow very carefully why.
Ja kun seuraa tarkasti miksi.
Why there is a historic celebration.
Miksi on historiallinen juhlinta.
Then you discover. You discover, discover.
Niin huomaat.
Then you discover that the reason there is a historic celebration is because
on koska
the most awaited day, most awaited, the Messiah went to the cross and he was abused.
Yeah, and
abused. He was murdered.
And
he was tortured. He was defiled. He was rejected.
He
was kicked
out.
Even the people asked for Barabbas. They said, give us Barabbas the robber, but don't give us Jesus. So it was bad. It was a severe suffering of the Messiah. And the Father watched from heaven.
Ja sitten isä katsoi taivaasta.
His son that had no sin.
Hänen poikansa, joka oli synnytön.
Coming to save sinful men.
Kuinka hän tuli pelastamaan synnytön.
But the sinful men he came to deliver refused to accept him. syntinen refuse to take it.
Niin kuin syntistä ihmistä hän ei voi ottaa vastaan.
He came to deliver the church.
Hän tuli vapauttamaan seurakunnan.
But the church refused. The Hebrew people refused.
Ja hebrealaiset kieltäytyivät ottamasta häntä vastaan.
So,
niinpä.
Look at this now. The Father watched the passion of the Christ. He watched the suffering of the Christ. He watched it.
Jeesuksen kärsimystä. Valtavaa kärsimystä.
He was abused.
Kuinka häntä vähän kohdettiin.
On the cross.
Ristillä.
And then.
Ja sitten.
When he went down.
Kun hän meni alas.
And for those of you tuned in by TV.
Ja niille, jotka teidästi seuraatte.
The Lord showed me how the Messiah was crucified one day.
Herra näytti minulle päivänä, kuinka Jeesus
Kristus. And I remember I wept for 3 months non-stop. 3 months non-stop.
Kolmen kuukauden aikaa jatkuvasti.
He even showed me how the Messiah went down.
Hän minulle kuinka Messias meni myös alas.
And then the measure of the glory came and took him from down there. The glory of the Lord came down and removed him from down there.
Kirkkaus tuli alas ja nosti hänet sieltä sitten.
And so it was a tremendous suffering.
Se oli valtava kärsimys.
But look at this now.
Mutta katsokaa tässä nyt.
When he resurrected.
Kun hän nousi myös.
He is now seated on the right side of the Father.
Hän istuu juuri oikealla puolella.
And ever since then.
Siellä hän istuu.
Heaven is asking.
Ja taivas kysyy.
The victory you achieved.
Että se voitto, jonka saavutit.
On the cross.
Ristillä.
The victory. Victory.
Voitto.
Jesus achieved on the cross.
Jeesus sai sen ristillä.
He came back for the church.
Hän sai sen seurakuntaa varten.
But where is the church?
Mutta missä on se seurakunta?
But where is the church? Because the victory,
koska voitto,
the Messiah took victory on the cross. He took it.
Messiah sai, otti ristillä.
But the question is why?
Kysymys on miksi?
Where is the church?
Missä on se seurakunta?
For which he suffered like that.
Jonka tähden hän kärsi näin.
Everybody focus on me now.
Kaikki keskittykää nyt minuun.
His body.
Hänen ruumiinsa.
Scars.
Arpia täynnä.
Including May 17th. May 17th.
Toukokuun 17. päivä. 2004.
When I saw a vision.
Kun näin näin.
I heard the trumpet of God.
Kuulin Jumalan pasuna.
I heard the voice of the archangel.
Ja arkkienkelin ääni kuulin.
And as I faced in that vision, as I faced the sky,
ja kun katsoin sinne kasvatusten,
the right hand side of the sky,
sen taivaan oikean puolelle,
then a cloud opened,
sieltä pilvi avautui,
and the Messiah stepped out into the sky,
ja Messias astui siihen taivaalle,
and I remember, that when he stepped out on the right side of the sky, the rightmost, when the cloud opened and he stepped out like this in the sky, the first thing I noticed was this. He has a crown. This time around, the Messiah has a crown. The other thing I noticed. Now I'm now sharing secrets of heaven with the church in Finland. The next thing I realized when he was there. Right and most. In the sky. The next thing I noticed. Was the sash, the red sash that runs from his shoulder down.
Oli semmoinen punainen viitta, joka tuli
kohdataan
alas, tämmöinen punainen nauha.
And the next thing he did, when he was sure that I am now focused on him, I'm seeing.
Hän tiedä, että olen keskittynyt häneen, näin hänet.
Finland, look at this.
Suomi, katsokaa tätä.
He did like this.
Hän teki näin.
He took his right hand.
Hän otti oikean kätensä.
And he showed me the nail pierced.
Ja näytti, että läristetyn kätensä.
That shocked me very much.
No way,
from the start. The first thing the Messiah did is to show me the nail pierced, the nails of the cross. He showed me.
In
other words, that event at Calvary.
Se tapahtuma Golgata.
That abuse at Calvary.
Se väärin kohtelu.
The suffering of the Messiah at Calvary.
Messiah kärsimys.
He now became part of his identity.
Siitä tuli osa hänen identiteettiä.
So that is how he introduced himself to me.
Niin hän esitteli itsensä minulle.
Introduced himself and showed the name Pierce like this, the glorious hand with the name Pierce. But focus on it now. And then he took that hand and he prepared the crown like this. So when he prepared the crown, the golden crown, then he began to walk from that side towards the left corner of this. And you can imagine for yourself how spectacular, how shocking, how magnificent, how historic, how dreadful, how fearful to see that, to see, just to see that. You can imagine what I went through by seeing. It's a wonder. You, I trembled when I looked at him. He walked from the other side to this side. I noticed something, that wherever his foot had stepped like that, okay, let me repeat for the TV audience, as he walked from the right hand side to the left hand side of the sky, wherever his foot stepped like this, I will see it remain glory, 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 glory. That shocked me. Because first of all, it made me understand. Wow! The King of Glory.
Wow, Kirka on kuningas.
He brought the glorious feet, his glorious feet. On our dusty road, on our muddy roads here. Dust and rain and mud.
Mutaisena teinämme pölyisyyttä, jossa on sadetta ja kaikkea roskaa.
Could it be true?
Voisiko olla totta?
That the King of Glory.
Että kirkkaan kuningas.
Loved us so much.
Rakkaa taisin meitä näin paljon.
That he brought his glorious feet, glorious feet.
Että hän toisi kirkkaan jalkansa.
To walk on this dirty road of ours here, the dirty roads. The dusty roads. On the mud where it rains, there is soil and mud. Could that be true? So I understood something new. That there is a price that Jesus paid which we may never understand in this life. Glory, 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 glory. I saw everywhere, he said, remain glory, glory. And I saw as he walked, the glory was pouring out of his feet. I was shocked by this. And so, when he reached the end, he took the other hand, the left hand now. He turned the face to me and took the left hand, please. And he took the left hand. And then he showed it to me also. And I saw the glory glowing from his hands. And I saw the glorious name pierced. The big nails of the cross. And you know those nails are big nails. Big nails, big ones. And the way it was being nailed, they had to fulfill prophecy when they nailed. So it was big nailed with impunity. For everybody to hear. The big nails. Then he showed me. I saw him, he showed me the nail pierce of the left hand. And then when I was looking at him, I don't know why I felt that this was good. I like this presence. I've seen the Lord. I like this. I felt it so good for me. I want to go to him. Remember at that time I was running away from the Lord. He was calling me, but I was running.
kutsuin.
So I was very shocked.
Olin todella shokkia.
That when I saw,
että kun näin,
I now told him.
Sano sanoin sitten hänelle.
Lord,
Herra,
please take me with you.
Ota minut sinun mukaasi.
I heard as if I was answered back. I heard as if I answered
you. Kuulin ikään kuin hän vastasi minulle.
He said,
hän sanoi,
your time is not yet.
Sen aikasi ei ole vielä.
But look at what happened.
Mutta katsokaa tätä.
Then he turned like this. He thought he looked down.
Hän katsoi alas.
After he showed me the left hand, he prepared the crown again. He left down. Ja
and
then he looked down. And he turned like this.
Ja kääntyi näin.
And he entered and the cloud covered like this.
Ja pilvi peitti hänet sitten.
So I want to ask you, beloved people.
Ja haluan kysyä teitä, rakkaat ihmiset.
Listen to me now.
Kuunnelkaa nyt minua.
The suffering of the Messiah, heaven saw, heaven saw.
Taivas näki Messiaan kärsimyksen.
The abuse of the Messiah, heaven saw.
Taivas näki Messiaan väärin kohtelun.
But where is the church?
Mutta entä seurakunta?
Where is the church for which the Messiah paid such a price?
Mutta missä on se seurakunta, josta Kristus maksoi niin suuren hinnan?
In Finland.
Suomessa.
He said.
Hän sanoi.
The name hears.
Että ne nauran lävistävät.
Turku. Tell the church of Christ all over Finland.
Kerro Kristuksen seurakunnalle ympäri Suomea.
Look.
paremmin.
But you are not yet delivered.
Mutta vielä vapautuneita.
You are born again.
Te olette uudesti syntyneet.
But you say you are not yet delivered.
Mutta kuitenkaan ette ole vapautuneet.
Why?
Miksi?
Because he saying in the book of Hebrews chapter 6 verses 4-6.
Hebrealaiskirjassa luku 6 ja
6. He saying that the blood of Jesus is the final sacrifice, maximum sacrifice. There is no other. Maximum. Sacrifice maximum. Can I read this? Hebrews chapter 6, 4-6.
Hebrealaiset luku 6 ja 4.
He says, it is impossible for those who have once been enlightened, for those who have tasted the heavenly gift, who have shared in the Holy Spirit, who have tasted the goodness of the Word of God and the powers of the coming age, if they fall away, to be brought back to repentance, because to their loss they are crucified Jesus again and again.
Maistaneet taivaallista lahjaa ja tulee osallisiksi pyhästä hengestä. Maistaneet Jumalan hyvää sanaa ja tuleva paananajan voimia, mutta ovat luopuneet. He näet itse uudestaan ristiin haavoittavat Jumalan pojan ja häpäisevät häntä julkisesti.
That is very shocking.
Se on niin shokeraa.
If you read that scripture,
jos katsot tämän kirjoitusti kohta,
he is actually speaking to the church.
Hän itse asiassa puhuu sille seurakunnalle.
He said,
hän sanoo,
those who have received the Holy Spirit,
ne, jotka ottavat pyhän hengen vastaan.
Those who are born again.
Jotka ovat uudesti syntyneitä.
Those who are children of God.
Jotka ovat Jumalan lapsia.
Those who have repented.
Jotka ovat tehneet parannuksen.
Those who know they are aware of the powers of the coming kingdom of the Messiah.
Jotka tuntevat ja ovat maistaneet tulevan maailman voimia.
So if you read that scripture, you know that he is talking to the church.
Jos luet kirjoituksia siitä, niin huomaat, että hän puhuu siellä seurakunnalle.
He